Hello everyone, welcome to the second lecture of sentence correction. The topic that we are doing this time is called parallelism. For the ones who did not attend the first lecture, I request you all to attend the first lecture, including the core concepts, practice exercise and assignments. This topic is very important from all major bank exams perspective, be it MBA or banking. Let's straight deep dive into the concepts. So this is something about myself. Let's move ahead. Now, when we try and understand parallelism, the first thing is, let's understand what it exactly means. Parallelism, in the most simplest sense, means trying to make the structure similar in any sentence. Now, basically what we're trying to do is we are trying to make the words, the phrases, or the clauses to be parallel in a sentence or similar in a sentence. Predominantly, there can be two types of errors. The first could be a parallel structure error. Let's look at a wrong statement here. Rahul's hobbies are singing, dancing, and to read books. Now, if you look at singing, this is verb plus ing. Dancing is verb plus ing. Read books is in the form of to plus verb. So that makes the whole sentence incorrect. The correct sentence will be if you make all the three elements as parallel. So singing, dancing and reading will be absolutely right. This is what is called as a parallel structure problem. The second type of most commonly asked questions are parallel comparison questions. Again, let us look at an example. Bangalore's weather is better than Mumbai. Are you able to figure out what is the problem with this sentence? Now, if you closely see, we are comparing the weather of Bangalore to the city Mumbai, which is a wrong comparison. Weather has to be compared to weather. Always remember, apples are always compared to apples. So the right answer will be Bangalore's weather is better than Mumbai's. So when you put an apostrophe S, it automatically implies the weather of Mumbai. Or you can also write it as Bangalore's weather is better than Mumbai's weather. So here you have explicitly mentioned the weather of both cities are as a comparison point. I hope this point is clear. Let's move to the approach that we need to have while solving such questions. For parallelism, there is a three-step approach that students must definitely follow. Now, whenever you find a question, always identify whether it is a parallel structure or a comparison problem. Let's say you've figured out it's a parallel structure problem. Then what you need to understand is each element that needs to be made parallel. So whatever is the sentence, you'll have to understand whether the elements are nouns, verbs, adjectives, or so on, and ensure that the sentences are all parallel and uniform. If it's a comparison question, like we did for Bombay and Bangalore, always look for words like as, like, then, that, and so on. These indicate comparison, and the right forms of comparison have to be made in the sentence. Let's look at more questions in terms of understanding how this approach actually works for a real question. Let's look at the question type. What happens when you have sentences separated by a comma? Let's look at this question. The reasons why Rahul could not join IIMA were insufficiency of funds. So this is what I refer as element one. Responsibility of supporting his family. This is element two. And he was in need of full-time employment. This is element three. Now, if you look at all the three elements, the first point that should come to your mind is the way these two are written, element 1 and 2, and the way element 3 is written. Element 3 introduces he as unnecessary pronoun because you already know that the question refers to Rahul. So the correct form would be the reasons why Rahul could not join IIMA were insufficiency, responsibility, and the need. In other words, if you look at these three types, you'll realize that these are all noun forms. This is a noun. Responsibility of supporting is a noun. And the need to take up is also a noun. So when you have three similar forms in a sentence, that sentence is bound to be correct. And that's what is meant by parallelism. Let's look at the next question. Your excuses are boring, childish, and show how ignorant you are. Now look at this. Boring. Boring means, boring is modifying excuses. Excuses are noun. So boring automatically becomes an adjective. Who is childish? The excuse is childish, which means this is also an adjective. But this part is unnecessarily elongated, which means you'll have to put this third part into these two forms. So the right answer will be your excuses are boring, adjective, childish, adjective, and ignorant, another adjective. So when you have all three elements as same, therefore parallelism is maintained and hence the right answer. I hope this concept is clear. Another important question type that's very common in exams is the active voice, passive voice mismatch. The logic is, if the structure is in active voice, then all the verbs that follow should also be in active voice and vice versa. Which means, if it's the structure of active voice, then the entire sentence will be in active. You cannot insert a passive voice inside and vice versa. For the ones who are not very clear what active voice means, active voice is a structure of a sentence which starts with a subject and ends with an object. Like for example, if I say, I was playing the guitar. Who was playing the guitar? Subject. This is verb. This is object. So this becomes an active voice statement. If I have to turn the same sentence into passive voice, I'll say, the guitar was played by me. Guitar is the object, this is the verb, and this is the subject. So depending on whether you're using active or passive voice, ensure that the structures maintain consistency. Let's look at a wrong sentence. My mother baked the cookie. Who baked the cookie? My mother. So this is nothing but your active voice. And the oven was cleaned by her. Oven is the object, this is the verb, and this is the subject. Which means the second part is in passive. So that makes the sentence incorrect. You cannot have an active-passive mismatch in the same sentence. The correct answer would have been, my mother baked the cake, which is in active voice. So this is active voice. This is V. And cleaned the oven. Who cleaned the oven? Mother cleaned the oven. So this part is also in active voice. So that makes the sentence absolutely correct. I hope you understood this question type. Let's move on to the next question type. What happens when you have correlative conjunctions and idiomatic expressions? So there are certain conjunctions in which words always come together. As you can see a list, it says if there is a not only, it will always follow but also. Similarly, the list, you can see two will also follow two. No sooner will follow then. Hardly, scarcely will follow when. So depending on how you want to put these conjunctions, ensure if one structure is there, the next structure has to be this. Let's look at an example. If I say, I like not only fruits, but also vegetables. Now this is an absolutely right statement, because your not only is referring to fruits and your but also is referring to veggies. So not only will always follow but also. That's the point. Also ensure that there are idiomatic expressions like prefer. So it is always prefer to. So you always say, I prefer coffee to tea, and not coffee than tea or over tea. Similarly, for mistake, you use for, you think of, or you think as something, you enable to. So these are certain expressions which always require a parallel structure. When I say parallel structure, it means that they always have a set pattern in terms of what is the next preposition that needs to be used, as mentioned here. Let's look at the sentence given here, and this is what we have already discussed. I not only like fruits but also vegetables. Can you figure out what is the problem? See, you have used not only and you have also used but also. The problem here is not only is used for like, whereas ideally not only should have been used for fruits. So, always remember that conjunctions should modify the right noun. So, this modification of the right noun is absolutely important while you're checking parallelism. Let's move on to the next topic. Now, what happens when you have gerunds, infinitives and participles? Right? Now, gerunds, infinitives and participles are all forms of verbs. Let's look at one by one. When we look at verb participles, you have either a present participle or a past participle. Present participle is nothing but an ing form of the verb. So examples here given are reading, singing and walking. But if I look at a past participle, it is nothing but the past tense or the second form of the verb. So walked, trained, drowned, all these are examples of past participles. Let's look at the second element, which is gerund. Gerund is a verb in ing, but it acts like a noun. And this is an important point to understand. So it is not just a verb in ing. It is a verb in ing which acts like a noun. So this point has to be understood. So example being dancing is my hobby. So here, although dancing is verb plus ing, but it acts like a noun. And how do you check it? If you replace dancing by any other noun, let's say I can replace dancing by saying cricket. And I can say cricket is my hobby. Cricket is a noun. And this sentence is right. Therefore, dancing also acts like a noun. That's how you check whether it's a gerund or not. Similarly, the next point is infinitive. Infinitives are in the form of 2 plus verb. So, I like to read, sing and dance. It is not mandatory to say I like to read, to sing and to dance. You can just put 2 here. As long as you're using the verbs in the same forms, they should be absolutely right and parallel. Let's take an example. Walking to the place. So walking as given here is verb in ing. Place of work is easier for me than to take. So to take is nothing but the infinitive form as given here. So verb in ing and infinitive is a mismatch. So the answer will be walking to the place of work is easier for me than taking the bus. So the right answer here will be taking the bus. Similarly, we are ready with our jackets in case it should rain. Now look at here. We are ready. Present tense. Should is future. And that's a mismatch. So it should be we are ready with our jackets in case it rains. Rains is again present tense. This is present tense. Hence the sentence is absolutely correct. Is it clear? I request you to please go through these question times one more time. Because these are all complex logic. And maybe looking at it once or twice will help you to understand it better. Let's move on. Now, we have in bits and pieces touched upon this topic of uniformity in tenses. Now, when we say uniformity in tenses, we refer that in any sentence, the sentence must be in the same tense. And that we have done in the previous concept also. That if it's in the present tense, it should continue in the present tense. Or if it's in the past tense, it should continue in the past tense. You cannot have mismatch of present and past together. Let's look at another question. He went home and was playing table tennis. He went home, which is past, and was playing. So, when he went home, he would have already played the tennis, which means this action is not happening. If this action is not happening, then past continuous is a wrong tense. So the right answer will be he went home and played tennis. This is second form of the verb in past tense. This is also second form of the verb and past tense. Therefore, parallel. There is, in recent times, lot of exams are asking this logic. Sometimes to make parallel, you also have to understand the context pretty well. Like for example, the baseball team gave up past 7 unearned runs in the second innings of today's game and still are losing in the 7th innings. Now look here, are losing is essentially present tense. But what you need to understand is the context, which means the baseball team gave up 7 runs in the second innings of today's game and still are losing means this part is happening. If this part is happening, it has to take a present tense. And gave up means this part happened in the past. So this complete sentence before the comma should be in past. So sometimes you might have a past and present together in the same sentence. But if the context is right, then these are also considered to be parallel. This is a very, very, very important concept. Please revise it 2 to 3 times before moving on. Let's move ahead. Comparisons is another point where we also see a lot of parallelism questions. Like initially we talked about how parallel structures can create a lot of questions. Parallel comparisons also can be a major chunk of questions. Let's look at how typically exams will trick you. The first predominant type of question is like versus as. Now this is a very, very common question that has been asked in a lot of exams. Now if you break down the structure, it means, let's understand what like means. Like is used when comparing similar qualities. So it is not the same quality, it is similar qualities. Let's look at an example. The eagle like the vulture. So is eagle the vulture? No. Therefore I've used like. So you're comparing similar qualities, not the same quality. As is used as a linking word in a comparison, it can also be used to introduce a comparative clause. Here, you compare same qualities, or you are talking about the same comparison. Here, you are talking about similar comparisons. Let's take an example. He went to Harvard. So this is a typo. He went to Harvard to do his MBA as his father, which means he has gone to Harvard. His father would have also gone to Harvard. So you're comparing same qualities. Another example which I can think of is if somebody asks you, please bring vegetables from the market. Bring vegetables from the market like potatoes. Now, when you use like potatoes, you have to bring vegetables which are not potatoes but something similar. So this is a point to understand. Something similar but not potatoes. But if you say instead of like, if you say as potatoes, then you will bring potatoes. So that's the point that I'm trying to drive home here. Let's look at another example. Cotton material absorbs perspiration better than synthetic material. So, cotton material absorbs perspiration better than synthetic material does. Why? Because you're comparing the absorption of cotton to absorption of synthetic material. Here it seems that absorption of cotton is compared to the material. So it is apple versus orange. So this is a wrong comparison. Right comparison would be absorption of cotton versus absorption of synthetic material. So this is again a right parallel structure. I hope this is clear. Let's move on. So that brings us to the end of parallelism concepts. Please revise it at least 2 to 3 times to get a grip of the concepts that we have discussed. Once you have done with the concepts, please proceed to the next video to solve and see the other practice questions and assessments. Thank you.